It began on a Tuesday night where I began having symptoms. I knew something was wrong, but I didn't know what was wrong. I had extreme sweating to the point as though someone threw water on me. I felt like I had heartburn. I couldn't even pick my dog up in the morning, and that's when I knew something was really wrong. So I told my mom I wanted to go to the ER. I explained what my symptoms were. Once I got to the ER, though, they did a whole bunch of tests on me. One test was a blood test, and it showed that my troponin was really high.
Looking at her EKG, it to me didn't look perfectly normal, so that's what kind of prompted me to say, all right, we need to do a little bit more investigation.
I remember it being very cold, and they told me that they did find a blockage, but they could not stent me. And I asked what that meant, and they told me that I had 100% blockage of my left main or my widowmaker, and that I would need open heart surgery. At 37, and I was fairly healthy, I was extremely shocked when I heard this.
You know, being a young woman and seeing a cardiologist come into the emergency room to evaluate when she just thought she might be having an asthma exacerbation, you know, that's nerve-wracking.
I was admitted to ICU with the thought that I would have surgery probably on Friday. My surgeon came to my room and he looked at me and my mom and told us that I would need open heart surgery that night. And they gave me the anesthesia and I was out. And then I came to, I don't know how many hours later, and I heard a nurse talking to me, telling me to wake up. Once the chest tubes were out, though, that was the start then of my recovery. I see it as almost a blessing because I've been able to affect other lives already, and I feel like I'm gonna continue to. I think that one of the most important parts of recovery is your support system. And I can't say enough about the kind of support that I got, not only from St. Luke's, but also, you know, through the American Heart Association.
The Heart Association is a great venue for patients to come together and volunteer and help spread the word of heart disease in the community.
Life is incredibly precious, and it can be taken away in a split second.
I think being informed about women's heart disease in particular is probably the number one thing that can help save people.
It's a passion of mine now to get my story out, to help others, and it really feels like this is what my purpose is now, to wanna do more with my life. I'm not just living each day, I'm actually doing something now with my life.